No. I mean, no. I've got it. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the only reason that I would lose the kids is if I can't prove that I have higher income than him. Well, yeah, I know I don't, but I will really soon. Look, I have to go now. You'll be by tomorrow then? Uh-huh. Say that again. Well, yeah, I've been doing everything I can to boost my income. I took a second job walking dogs. I even created my own store on Etsy to sell crafts. I'm even renting out my home to a production company. Oh, it's Indie. Yeah. Listen, the producer's actually here right now to go over the contracts. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's always so nice chatting with you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Hey, bye.
Hot Carl, pleased to meet you.
I'm sorry.
No, about the phone call, not about your name. You have a great name.
Thank you. It used to be Don K. Punch. But as it turns out, there are already two other guys with that name starring in Kung Fu flicks. I'm sorry it took me so long to swing by. Things have been absolutely swamped at the Stiff Peter headquarters from the move, you know. So let's get down to the business of it. Now, it's important for you to know that here at Stiff Peter, we create artwork with the deepest of meaning.
How deep?
To the hilt.
You know, I know I'm not the most cultured person, but I'm sure your work is really complex.
Très.
Wow. Your numbers are amazing. You must have a lot of viewers.
We stopped counting at 69, eh? And your beautiful home will bring in so many new ones. That balance it strikes between that classic Victorian and that home sweet home antebellum, simply charming, merveilleux. We'll try to keep the spunk up the walls, eh? Now, we have work to do. Misty Cavern, Fat Frank, mes amis bien, Sherry.
Mwah.
Mwah. Mwah. Plus tard, ça c'est plus tard. Misty, Fat, Frank, this is Debbie, our host.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Fat Frank, pleased to meet you.
Should I call you Fat or Mr. Frank?
Frank's just fine.
Well, this tete-a-tete has been a little slice of heaven and all, but Frank, we should really get to work. This pussy ain't gonna pound itself.
Oh, nothing but a piece of meat to these people.
Passion, Misty. Oh. I need you to use this. Soak in your environment around. No, don't just moan around. You're a flower in a garden of love. His stamen oozes for you. Let it all pollinate you.
Or taste my sweet nectar.
Yeah. I'm gonna blast my seed all over your face.
Yes.
Turn your back on. That was absolutely perfect. Another masterpiece. That's why I hire you guys. Debbie, can I bother you for a cleaning wipe?
You know they're my kids too. Oh, of course, they're asleep already. You're fine. Whatever. Goodbye.
Hey.
Oh, Jesus!
I'm so sorry.
What the hell are you doing here? I thought you guys were done shooting over an hour ago.
We were, but I think I left my phone.
Just hurry up. I need to go to bed.
I think it might have ended up in one of the cushions here. May I?
Here, let me see.
Thank you.
Why is this spot sticky?
Oh, well, that was Misty Cavern, I swear. You know, when it comes to squirting, that woman's like a can of Pringles. Once she pops, can't stop. Yeah, well, Misty's an explicit woman.
Yeah, it certainly seems that way.
So, I couldn't help but overhear your conversation from outside the window over there. You having some trouble with your baby daddy?
Oh, you heard that. Yeah, I have some problems, but it's nothing I can't handle.
Such as?
Don't you think that's kind of personal? I mean, I don't even know you.
Hey, I'm a nice guy. I don't bite, unless you ask me to.
Okay. Well, I'm sure you figured out that money's the problem. Mm. I mean, I wouldn't be letting you guys film this stuff here for my health.
I don't know. A little bit of this stuff. I'm just teasing.
No, it's all right. I'm just so wound up over the CPS thing.
CPS thing?
Yeah, if I don't figure out a way to make more money, my ex is threatening to take custody away from me.
Well, what does that have to do with the CPS?
My ex is a pretty vindictive guy. I mean, all it took was one phone call, and now the CPS is involved. This agent's coming over here tomorrow to evaluate me. And I mean, I know you guys are gonna be done by the time she gets here, but just having you here is really putting me on edge.
Well, I wouldn't worry about it too much. Carl's the type of guy who likes to get things done ahead of schedule, so we should be out of your hair with plenty of time. And for what it's worth, you seem like an intelligent, capable woman. Not to mention, beautiful. I'm sure you'll figure it out.
Thank you. You seem like an upstanding guy yourself.
That's what they tell me, at least. Well, I'll let you get back to whatever it is you were doing.
Okay.
I'll see you tomorrow.
It's you.
No, it was last time I checked.
Misty, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So, how's it going in there?
You tell me. How'd it sound out here?
Very intense.
Good. But it's one of the three things you have to make it in this industry. Intensity, intelligence, and integrity. It's the triple I's of the adult film industry.
So, when did you, or how did you get started in the adult?
You mean porno.
Yeah, porno.
I mean, same way most women do, I guess.
Drugs?
No, not drugs. With an MBA in finance and too few job prospects. Throw in, like, tank load of student debt, and voila, porn. Granted, I wish I had some time to do drugs.
So, you got into it, like, immediately after college?
No, not right after. Honestly, I'd been too busy studying. I kind of lost myself in college. By the time I graduated, I didn't know who I was anymore. I wanted to travel. I wanted to see the world. So I packed my bags and I headed to Japan. I was teaching English to school kids there for a few years before I fell in with a group of competitive eaters. We traveled around internationally, competing for like a year or two, but after a whirlwind romance with Takaru Kobayashi went south, I had to come home.
Who's that?
Oh, he's the six-time Nathan Top Dog Coney Island eating champion.
No shit.
No shit.
Wow. Oh my God, it sounds like so adventurous and fun and exciting.
I mean, yeah, it is. It's all fun and games until you end up in the hospital. It kind of loses its appeal after the second bypass.
So, do you have any plans for the future? I mean, I'm just curious, like, how long can you do what you do?
Thanks, Mom. No, honestly, women like me are always going to be in demand. Have you seen the internet? There's a page for every fetish you can think of, and two more for every one that you can't. You've got your Rusty Kaisers, your Yum Bag Yahtzees, your, Jesus, your Slow Charlies.
Slow Charlies?
Yeah. So, a guy puts on a burlap diaper and you asked. I shouldn't know stuff like that.
You shouldn't. Don't take this the wrong way. You fascinate me. Are you proud of what you do?
Yeah, I am. It's some humanitarian shit that I'm doing, too. No, it's not just the films with Hot Carl.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You know, Kofi Annan presented me with an award in front of the UN for my progressive and outstanding work in the field. I was the first actress to be in a scene with someone from all seven continents. Called it the first global gangbang.
Most people in Antarctica?
Yeah, but it's fine. We figured if we shot there, it would kind of count. A waddle of penguins right there, and I swear on my life, some of them were watching. I'm not joking. Waddles.
So you win an award for that?
Yeah, I mean, it's not so crazy when you think about it. People have been trying to get the nations of the world to come together for centuries. I'm just the first woman who actually did. Granted, one of them finished early, but I don't think anybody was really keeping track of that.
Do you enjoy it?
What?
Sex?
God, yes. You have to love it to be in this industry.
Well, okay, I get that. Obviously you do. But I mean, like, the whole on-camera portion of it. Being in front of the whole wide world.
You know what? I really do. I mean, think about it. I get to have sex with people I like whenever I want, wherever I want, no matter how much I want. Plus, the money is more than adequate. It's honestly just like real life, except that sex is so good. Like so good.
Mm. So you make pretty decent money then?
Yeah, I mean, it's somewhere between like living large money and fuck you money.
Admit, I'm a little bit jealous. I've been in a world of hurt these days, financially.
Really? Drugs?
Kids.
Oh.
You know, being a single mom, it's hard, you know, just trying to keep everything afloat and get dinner on the table every night.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Oh my God, what I would give for one night with some really good drugs.
No, when Kobayashi and I split, I got land in custody of our pet spider monkey, Dr. Giggles. He only eats Nathan's hot dogs. Little bastard's gonna land me in the poorhouse, I swear to God. And that'll be my cue. Gotta stack that paper. I'll catch you later, hon.
Hey, it was really nice to talk with you, and thanks for helping me fold the laundry.
Yeah, no, of course, there's no problem. And look, if you're really serious about needing, like, a little bit of extra cash, I'm sure that I could talk to Carl about getting you a job as a fluffer or a stand-in or something like that.
Fluffer?
Later. Ciao, darling. Coming, Carl.
Come in, it's open. I thought I told you it was open.
Nice to finally meet you, Debbie.
Hi. You're here.
Yes.
You're really here.
You were expecting me, weren't you?
No.
No.
I mean, yes. I just wasn't expecting you so early.
I come when I'm ready. People like it if you let them know you're coming before you come, but not me. I prefer to come when my clients aren't expecting it. The expression on their face is always priceless.
It's really secret. Studio stuff, non-disclosure agreements, all that.
Oh, okay.
Axiom.
As you can see, safe for the kids.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Oh, and you have to see the backyard. It's the best part of the house.
Oh.
You can see how big it is, and the kids have a great place to play and get out.
Yes. Well, it is a very nice yard. However,
and you have to see my. I'm so proud of these eggplants. You know, they're almost award-winning.
Oh. They are?
Yeah,
they are.
I've been very working nice on these for months.
Oh.
They're my pride and joy right now.
I wouldn't have expected that. They're lovely.
Oh.
So big. No, I have a garden as well. I like to grow vegetables.
You would not believe the dialogue in this scene. So beautifully artistic. Oh. Hello. You must be the actress for the next scene. I was told she'd be quite loud. Are you sure? You could be if you wanted.
No. This wonderful woman right here, she works for the government. Someone who has a lot of authority, someone that we should be really, really nice to.
I see. The government. Always passing all of that legislation that is killing my business, no?
I'm not in that branch of the government.
Does not matter, all the same
pigs.
Yes, he is, and he should go back to directing in the other room. I'm really sorry about that.
It's fine. Oh, you read this too?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The articles are very well written, I have to say.
Yeah.
We're on break. I will see you later.
He's an interesting character, isn't he?
Yeah, you know, those artistic types.
Oh, I do know, actually. You know, I was an extra on a film once.
Really?
Yeah, I played Girl Who Dies Number 4.
Oh, wow.
And you're right, these artistic types can be so, what's the word? Egotistical.
Absolutely, yep, absolutely. Well, I mean, not all of them are,
I like you, Debbie. You're a good person.
Really?
Yeah. And you know, I like how you look for different methods of income on top of a job. It shows responsibility on your part.
Oh my God. You have no idea how relieved I am for you to
say that right now.
Thank you. Thank you. I try.
Yeah.
I really do.
You know, I'm going to present your case to my superior, and I think he's going to be very satisfied with what he hears. I think I can make a good argument here for joint custody. Just one more thing. Can I finish the article in this magazine?
Oh, yeah. It is yours. You can have it. I will get you a subscription.
Thank you. The articles, they're very well written.
Sorry. Don't mind me. You lost my beads around here. You haven't seen them, have you? Expecting someone.
You know, it's not good actors.
Yeah.